Before leaving the world of Pooh, I'm dropping in at the pretty village of Hartfield, where A.A. Milne and Christopher Robin used to live.
Hi there, Michael.
How are you?
Thank you very much, Neil.
Neil Reed is the proud owner of Pooh Corner, a cafe, shop and museum.
So, Pooh Corner, but this is not the house?
No, this isn't the house the books were written in. This is actually Christopher Robin's sweet shop.
Do we know what he liked to eat by way of sweets?
He was a huge fan of bullseyes, and what he would do, he would come in and buy a penny's worth, and he'd actually feed them to his donkey. Her name was Jessica.
So not even the same gender as Eeyore.
I think Eeyore was basically the noise that Jessica probably made.
Through this door must come Winnie the Pooh lovers from all over the world, I suppose.
We've had 45,000 people recorded through this door last year. And for books that are now 95 years old, heading up to be 100, and still be talked about in this level, it's special.
Well, I feel it's time for a little something. Honey sandwiches, perhaps?
Be rude not to, wouldn't it?
The Pooh books have stayed with me all my life because of the authenticity of the characters. The simple-minded bear who is easily satisfied, the ever-loyal and rather naive Piglet, the eternal pessimist Eeyore, the worldly wisdom of Owl, which in a way is a bit fake, and the fact that Christopher Robin cannot postpone his departure from childhood. We're borne along on a wave of nostalgia, as surely as a Pooh stick is carried down the river.